Hello everyone, my name is Thabiso Nketsi and today we will be going through a well-known movement practitioner who is Pina Pasach. And we're going to be going through her biography, her theoretical practices, as well as her philosophy and practical methods. So let's get started with her biography.
Pina Basarch was born in 1940 in Seligen and died in 2009 at Wuppertal. She received her dance training at Folkweg School in Essen under Kurt Jooss, where she achieved technical excellence. Soon after, the director of Wuppertal Theatres, Arno, engaged her as a choreographer from Aton. 1973, she renamed the ensemble the Tenzin Theatre Wuppertal. Its combination of poetry and everyday elements influenced the international development of dance. Pina Pasach is one of the most significant choreographers of our time. Pina Pasach was later to gain international standing from nearby Wuppertal with her dance theatre. The proximity of the other arts taught at Folkwagen School include opera, music, drama, sculpture, painting, photography. Design was also an important influence on her, reflected later in the form of a wholly open approach to the media in her work as a choreographer.
All right, from what we have read about her biography, we can tell that Pina Pasach was an excellent movement choreographer. As we can see that she got a chance to choreograph at Wuppertal Theatre, and she also got a chance to rename the theatre to Tenzin Theatre. And she was influenced by the school that she attended, which was Folkwagen School, where she got to master her craft and to improve her movement craft. Now we're moving to her practical theoretical practices and as well as her philosophy.
Her parents ran a restaurant in Seligen attached to a hotel where, along with her siblings, Pina helped out. She learned to observe people above all fundamental things which drive them. Passage's work tries to mirror the various situations of our existence in patinam and dance images supported by music. Pina Passage had finally found the form her work would take. It's dreamlike. Poetic imagery and body language justifying the worldwide success she soon achieved. Passage performs practice is built on a process of uncovering connection to fundamental ideas and feelings.
All right, from the previous page that we have read, basically here we can tell that Pina Pasarch doesn't just choreograph things for the sake of choreographing, but she tries her utmost best to understand human beings and how they do things. So most of her choreographed work is based on people and what they exactly do, how they live, how they feel, and how they do things. She doesn't just come up with them out of her head, but she studies human beings. As we have read that since she worked at her father's restaurant from a young age, she just enjoyed watching people and trying to understand their existence. So right now we're going to go to her practical methods on how she does her choreography so we can understand basically how she incorporates people's existence into her work.
Her pieces are built on brief episodes of dialogue and action that are often centered on surreal situation, prop, or costume. Passage has said that she's never considered what she does as choreography, but the most well-known statement by Passage comes from an interview with Jo Chen, in which she says, "I'm not interested in how people move, but what moves them." As in expressive dance, which looked to everyday movement to express personal experiences and which gained popularity in the 1920s, Passage aims to use emotive gesture, but in a new way as expressing feelings by whatever means will best convey
From
them.
what I've read and gathered on Pina Passage is that She likes to basically involve her emotions and also past experiences in her movement piece or choreography. She likes expressing how she feels as well as her past emotions, and she likes it when her dancers do the same thing and they can express any feelings of love, of, I don't know, jealousy, of hate, but never violence. She doesn't condone violence in any of her pieces, but most of the time she tells stories of love, and she uses props and costumes to tell the story quite well. So what we can see is that Pina Bausch basically involves emotion in everything that she does. Anything. So a good dancer to her is a person who can basically express her emotions or his emotions very well through the movement. That's a good dancer for her.